Josh, I don't know whether to start talking about the offense or the defense. Everything works so well. Let's talk defense first.
Holding Baylor to 31% from the field. That's an excellent one.
Yeah, that's exactly what we wanted to establish. You know, sometimes the shots aren't going to fall on the offensive end, so you got to be consistent defensively. And you know, we had a great game plan going in. We really followed the scouting report defensively and didn't give them anything easy. So I think once we got on them early, it made it tough on them and kind of took them out of their comfort zone. So that was big for us.
And the scouting report offensively must have worked too, because you figured out how to crack that zone.
Yeah, definitely. We worked really hard at it, you know, the past few days of going against that zone. You know, we didn't have to do anything special. We didn't put any you know, new schemes or anything like that in there. We just did what we always do. Try to get the ball in the middle, touch Frankie in there, let him make some plays, and, you know, we got an opportunity to shoot from the outside, knock him down.
Nice to play from ahead instead of coming back?
It really is. I mean, totally different game than the last one we played against Oregon. So, you know, Baylor's a team that's gotten on teams early in this NCAA tournament run they've had, so we definitely wanted to establish that early, and it was just great to not only get that lead but kind of control it throughout the entire game.
Frank Kaminsky with 19 points tonight. Frank, you started aggressive early and stayed that way the rest of the night. That was the game plan, I assume?
Yeah. You know, we wanted to get into the middle of that zone and attack them and, you know, get some easy baskets and then stop them defensively. We were able to do that.
What was the big factor on having such a great night defensively?
You know, just preparation. You know, we had almost a week to prepare for this team. You know, right when we saw them beat Creighton, you know, we were ready to go for them. And, you know, we had that whole week, and we've had a couple practices here, and it's just been great to prepare for them.
Is it better to have a game where you're ahead and the lead doesn't get close instead of having to come from behind all the time?
Yeah, we talked about it earlier, you know, stepping on people's throats and not letting them back in the game, and we were able to do that tonight.
Ben Brust and the Badgers into the Elite Eight, and Ben, let's talk about this game tonight. As complete an effort as maybe you had all year?
Yeah, there was some good balance across, you know, our scoring, and we did a good job of making Baylor take some tough ones. They didn't shoot particularly well from three, but we did a good job of cleaning up the glass because they got some big, tall, lengthy guys who can really offensive rebound and crash the glass, so I think we did a great job there.
Everyone wondered after watching Baylor on Sunday, how are you guys going to crack that zone? But you found some spots.
Yeah, I think we got, you know, some big guys who can catch the ball in good areas and either shoot it, drive, pass, do whatever, or get fouled. So we got some guys who we can put in some situations that make good things happen in the middle of that zone, and Frank did a great job today.
And once you got the lead, man, it didn't get close at all. You really kept your foot on the accelerator, too.
Yeah, that was good. And, you know, that was good to make sure that once we got the lead, we kept it and grinded it out and kept extending that. And I'm still dancing as a senior, so I'm a happy man.
How fun is this run?
This is great. This is great. I mean, I love my teammates, so that makes it even better, you know, to do this with some guys that I care about. And can't wait to go play on Saturday.
Yeah, Saturday will be the day. We'll be back in Anaheim with the Badgers and the Elite Eight. Bo, anybody who watched the Baylor game was thinking, how are they going to crack that zone? You guys figured it out, it seems.
Well, our guys did a great job of court awareness, spacing, ball fakes, and being unselfish. You know, Frank Kaminsky was the leader of that inside. Trey Jackson from the guard position and everybody else chipped in, and we got some good angles. We got some pretty good finishes. And once we got them to the point where they were guessing at times, that really helps when you're attacking the zone. So fortunately, we got some buckets early and maybe had them thinking a little bit.
And on the defensive end, you hold Baylor to 31% shooting. That worked out pretty well for you, too.
Yeah, I thought our defense played really well. You know, a couple breakdowns. But overall, I thought they did a great job of taking away the strengths of Baylor.
Yeah. And once you got the lead, you kept the foot on the accelerator, and they never really got back in it.
Well, we tried to, you know, we tried to make it a little larger, so in case when they did hit their hot streak, I mean, they've gone through stretches where they've scored, you know, like 2.5 points per possession, you know, where they hit 5 threes in a row and then a and one. And so, I mean, Baylor's an explosive team. Fortunately for us, we didn't let them get into that.
Yeah, you said you thanked your team for taking you along on this ride, right? Yeah. And the ride continues.
I said, thanks for letting me come along to Anaheim. And, you know, I'll hang around as long as you guys want me to and as long as we're here. So we got another 40 minutes, and that's what we wanted, and that's what we have.
Well, hang around till Saturday.
Okay.
Have some fun. Badgers back at the Elite Eight.